Yamada.
I would like to add a few words. In dealing with the Fukushima Daiichi accident, one of the most frustrating time was at the beginning 2 or 3 days. During that time, we tried to get information from Japan. We have established contact with the Japanese authority, but we could not have enough information. The reason is that all the instrumentations of the reactors were knocked out by tsunami. There was a complete blackout, and we couldn't have enough or minimum information. And we did not know what is happening, and we could not inform people, media, what was happening. If the same thing happens, not by tsunami, but by cyber attack, we will be in the same situation. That will be a very dangerous situation.
This idea of the threat model, I think, is very important. It's not generally known, but I believe it's a fact that U.S. nuclear plants have been hardened to withstand today an airplane crashing into them, which is obviously a result of September 11th. I'm glad you brought us back to Fukushima, because I wanted to continue our conversation on that. Does the radiation from Fukushima represent a threat to any other country other than Japan?
I don't think so. We have to, when we discuss the radiation, we have to distinguish two things. If you are exposed to a very strong radiation for a long time from a short distance, that is dangerous, and you may be killed even. And that could happen at the site or nuclear explosion. This is called the deterministic effect. If you are distant from the site, off-site, let's say 20 kilometers or 30 kilometers or 50 kilometers, you may be exposed to radiation. And if you are exposed into such environment for a long time, in 10 years' time, in 20 years' time, you may have cancer. But that is some other question within 20, 30, 50 kilometers range, radials. We have monitored the radiation level all over the world, and we have detected some change, but the change or fluctuation was minuscule, and that is far from affecting the human health. Our human body is made to be resistant to the radiations that exist everywhere in the nature, including in this room. Radiation comes from the stone, concrete, from space, from everywhere. So I can tell you that radiation increase caused by Fukushima Daiichi accident in distant countries does not affect human health.
Then how do you explain the fact that, as a German friend of mine put it to me right after Fukushima, from the reaction, from the hysteria in Germany, you would have thought those reactors were in Darmstadt rather than in Fukushima?
This is a question of confidence. And as radiation cannot be seen, people have a psychological fear. And this is a very serious problem. After the Fukushima Daiichi accident, I got a letter from one person whom I don't know. And he said that he bought a radio, and that was made in China. But later he found that one piece, parts, was made in Japan. And he asked me if he can listen to it. So I wanted to tell him, if you don't eat radio, you are safe. But I didn't say that.
How much of a threat does the radiation represent to Japan, particularly given the fact that Japanese officials have been quoted as saying that it'll be decades before people can move back into that vicinity?
It depends area. And in order to identify, we have to make a good contamination map. And there are so-called hot spots where level of radioactivity is rather high. It's better not to go there or decontaminate the soil. In case of food, in some type of food, radiation is some level is high. But government is monitoring. And actually, if you don't keep on eating, that does not cause some damage, negative impact to health. But if the government gives some warning, it's better not to eat it.
Two last questions on this subject. What do you think the future of nuclear power is in Japan?
That is very difficult to foresee, and there is uncertainty. It is understandable that when people have strong fear, because the accident happened, people are forced to evacuate from the 20 kilometer radius, 30 kilometer radius, and accident has not yet come to an end. It seems to me that constructing new power plants would be difficult. We are now discussing with the Japanese government. Japan is conducting so-called stress tests to examine whether the nuclear power plants withstand the severe natural hazards like tsunami, earthquake, or flood. IAEA is prepared to re-examine what they have done. If they resume the operation of nuclear power plants, it's better to do it after safety is ensured by the government and perhaps reviewed by the IAEA.
That was my second question. How soon do you think you'll be able to give such assurance?
We are ready to go, and it doesn't take much time. This is essentially a computer modeling, and they can do it in weeks' time or maximum a couple of months. And if we are given the chance, opportunity, we can do it rather quickly. We can send mission to help Japanese operators or authority. It doesn't take years. It will take weeks or months maximum.